Hello guys, welcome back to Automation eLearn. In this lecture, I'm going to talk about one tricky question related to Git. So guys, in one of my previous lecture, we discussed like how to use gitignore file in Git. And there we discussed everything about gitignore, how to define a set of rules in this so that Git can ignore those files and folders accordingly. So that was all about gitignore. Based on that, so there is one interview question. So basically that is a tricky interview question that generally people ask is like, in Git, I want to ignore files and folders without using gitignore files. So as of now, we have seen like using gitignore file to ignore the files. But the question is, without using gitignore, how can we ignore files and folders in Git? So let's see practically what is the problem statement and how we can ignore files and folders without using gitignore. So I'm back to my repository. This is the same repository which I have used when I was discussing about gitignore, and this is the file gitignore, and we have defined set of rules over there. So based on the repository folders and files, I have included files which I don't want Git to track. So just to give a brief idea what we have done so far, I have included all the files which are starting with a dot and all the folders which should not be the part of my repository, like logs, uploads and target, etc. Right, so we have defined a set of rules, and if I'll check status, there is nothing much listed, right? The files and folders which we have defined in the gitignore, those are not listed by Git here. So this was all about gitignore, and using gitignore file we can ignore the files and folders easily, right? But the question is, without using gitignore, how can we ignore the files? So let me first rename this file. Okay, so how can we do that? As soon as we initialize our repository, we get a .git folder created, and .git is basically having all the information about my repository, all the commits, everything, where is head pointing to, what is the remote URL, each and everything. .git folder is having all the information, right? And this is the folder which is not even being tracked by Git also. So if you look at my gitignore, I have not defined .git folder over here, right? And it is also not being shown here, right? So .git is a folder which will not track by Git. So inside .git, we have a couple of folders. So what is the purpose of having these files and folders, that we will discuss in a separate lecture. So guys, there is one folder called info. And if you'll go inside info, there is one file called exclude. So this is a normal text file. You can open it with Notepad. And it has few comments. So this is the file. This is the file which is present under .git info. So this file will behave exactly like a gitignore. So if you look at the status now, so git bash has listed all the files and folders which are untracked. These files and folders should be ignored, but those entry we have made in gitignore, and if you look at, we have renamed gitignore file, so it will not serve the purpose. So that's why we wanted to use info and exclude file. If I'll make an entry like logs/*, and save it. So in a git bash, if you noticed, logs folder is listed over here, and we have mentioned rules for logs in exclude file. So let me check status now. Let me increase it. Yeah, so earlier log was showing, and now the log folder is not listed over here. It means exclude file is behaving exactly like a gitignore. Let's add few more rules over here, like downloads. Uploads and target. What else is there? Dot class path. Okay, let's check with those files only. and do status. Again, if you see the files and folder which we have included in the exclude file will not be listed over here, right? So earlier class path was shown, but we have added that in the exclude, so it is not showing now. So that's how we can use exclude file to ignore files and folders. So in a brief, we can say there is a file called exclude which is present under .git folder inside info. So exclude is the file which we can use as a git ignore. So there are two different approaches, right, to ignore files and folders. So let's also understand what is the difference between these two approach. So when we use git ignore file to ignore files and folders, so the benefit with this is like we can check into our repository, we can commit this to our repository, right? So we have that file which is being tracked by git, so we can commit that file, git ignore file, to our repository, and it will also serve the purpose to my colleagues as well. So anybody can use this git ignore and the rules that we have defined inside it to exclude the files and folders which are not supposed to be part of repository. So that is the one point. What is with the exclude? So that is anyways under .git folder, and we discussed that .git folder will not be tracked by git. So this is only for your local. This file we cannot commit to repository. This file we cannot share it with anybody. So that is the one big difference between these two approaches. And I hope you are clear with the answer now. That's what I wanted to discuss in this lecture. Let me know in the comment section in case of any doubts or any question, or you have any concern or any other topic that you want me to explain in my lectures. That's it guys. In the next video, I'll come with another tricky interview question, and see you then. If you like the video, you can subscribe to my channel for many more learning going ahead. Thank you for running this one. Thank you.